school psychologist. I'm here to talk to you today about change.
Oh no.
Yeah. Because let's face it, nobody likes change. Except maybe a wet baby. Not like a wet baby, but a little resistant to change. I'd love for us to have an open dialogue, share some of the changes that have been happening for you at work, in your school district, maybe things you've been talking about here at this conference, some challenges, just go ahead and shout them out. I've got all night. I'm sure you've heard that before. Maybe new parking, changing in faculty. Air conditioning, that has to be big in Texas, right?
Facilities.
We have to explain that a little bit more to me.
We don't have enough buildings for the students.
Not enough buildings for the students. That is a common problem. You know, that's so very interesting. And I don't know who I'm talking to. Would you mind coming up and sharing a little bit more about that with us? I promise it will be painless. I don't even know who I'm talking to. Come on up. Give her a round of applause. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I will take a reluctant volunteer any day. You're all teachers, you know that, right?
Hello, Julie.
Julie, that's one of my favorite things.
Julie needs a little more encouragement.
Please give a round of applause for Julie. She has the most beautiful hair I've ever seen.
And she has really great hands.
Oh, Julie, thank you so much. I don't know how, these are a little tricky, these seats, but we love them. Here you go, Julie. Thank you so much for joining us. This is going to be painless, I promise. Absolutely. You don't believe me. I will take care of you, Julie. All right, so facilities. You don't have enough space. You've got too many students, huh?
Yes, we have 1,000 on the waiting list.
1,000? It's a popular school. Well, you know what we're going to have right now? A little group therapy session about change. And you know what, Julie? You can just sit back and relax. You don't have to say a word at all. Yeah, see? She likes that. The session will begin very shortly. Don't worry. It's going to start very soon.
Well, hey, no, I got to go because I'm walking into group. Yeah, that's right. Okay. Well, I will see you later. Okay, bye-bye. With you.
Woo! What are you doing?
Oh, hey, Dr. Bond, don't mind me. I'm just testing out the old motion-controlled mobile classroom, or MC squared, as I call it. It's the latest thing in high-tech learning. It's like having an Xbox, a Skype, a telephone, a neat platform all rolled into one. It's totally awesome.
Yeah, what?
Yeah, you know, it's the same technology James Cameron used when he was making Avatar. And I got these bad boys, and they are A-okay.
Why don't you introduce yourself to our new group member? This is Julie.
Julie, how you doing? Hey, Schmee, the superintendent there of District 214. Don't call me doctor, don't call me mister, just call me Hank, because I like first names. They make for closer communication, don't they? Yeah, they do. Yeah, they do.
I'm so sorry that I'm late. They were giving technology training and I needed to be there. There's somebody new in the class.
That's right. This is Julie. Oh, she is silent but fabulous. Alright? Donnie, come have a seat, alright? Alright, please introduce yourself to Julie.
Hey, Julie, I'm Donnie. And you see, I am horrified by change. There I said it.
Okay, yes, wonderful. Alright. Well, Julie was just saying that we have over 1,000 people on the wait list to try and get into her school in enough room.
Oh my gosh.
I know. How do you cope with that?
Well, not very well. Usually when the parents come in,
Yeah. Who parents, am I right?
Oh. You know what I do, Julie? I drink.
Oh, okay. Okay. I noticed you're very anxious.
I am. I came in here today to work on a specific problem. If you don't mind, Julie, if you don't mind, Hank, if
I Oh, no, hey, you do your thing. I do mine as we meet. Great. If not, well, it can't be helped.
Go ahead. But remember what I said, honey. Being anxious about change is just a fear of losing control.
Yes, and that's just it, Dr. Vaughn. I have no control, none. Not an ounce of it. Julie, I have been in education for 23 years, okay? So I have lived through open classrooms, back to basics. Whole language hooked on phonics. Higher standards, no standards, you do your thing, but don't do that thing. Student-based education, art-based education, brain-based education, project-based education, mastery learning, master teachers, merit pay, mentorship programs, curriculum mapping, domains, dibbles, NCI, NCLB. No child left behind, whole child, I've done it all! Woo! Technology. My kindergartners don't even talk to each other anymore. They just blog and tweet. You know, the other day, a girl told me she flickered. I sent her to the school nurse. Understand. And they're always talking about some cloud, like they're in it. Whatever it is.
Well, if I may interject. So cloud technology is really cool. It's a bioelectronic environment, and it's inhabited by applications and information. I mean, there was no software to install, and it's literally universal. I mean, think about it this way, okay? Cloud technology is like the next great frontier, okay? And we are all its pioneers, right? All right, right? So I say climb on the wagon, gang, because we're heading west. Cloud computing, oh! Yeah!
Sometimes I think you just like change for change's sake.
Well, right, you are, little Dot. Change is awesome, and I'm out there on the edge, and I want my faculty out there with me, you know? On the edge.
All right. Hey, let's face it, you have this need to change everything. What? Right? You're addicted to change.
No. I am a change user, not a change abuser, okay? I got my start with change when I was doing like transactional analysis. Okay, so yeah, you know, I'm okay, and you're all okay, and I mean that you're all okay. But you know, I took this concept back to my faculty, and we created an enormous "we're all okay" corral. And everything was going fine until that unfortunate verbal shootout.
And you got fired.
Right, but landed on my feet, and I went on to change everything I could in my next 16 schools, huh? So, but as Dr. Bond says, you know, let's be here now. But hey, I think that this mobile classroom can really change the face of education, you guys. You know, I have a program in here, and it's all about parasailing with El Duario. Very
educational. You enjoyed that one?
Yeah. I'm working on my skill. But look, my point is, I want teachers who aren't afraid of students knowing more about social networking than they do. You know, I want my entire district to be on a 10G wireless hotspot, hooked up to a smart grid. But none of the dinosaurs on the school board are ever going to go for that, so I guess we're going to have to quit.
Hank, you are reacting to change, getting frustrated, feeling helpless. Okay, when you respond to change, you choose to let it affect you positively.
Yeah, but I can see where education's going, Dr. Bond. Do you realize in the next decade, we're going to have to hire 200,000 new teachers? And they're gonna have to be wireless to the max.
I've heard enough, Julie. Let's get a drink.
Look, we all applaud your enthusiasm for change, but I think we need to remember our three rules of change. And Julie, this is your time to shine. Will you please read that first rule? Be clear on how you want to handle change.
Oh, that was the most beautiful one I've ever heard in the entire world.
Meryl Streep here. And Dottie, will you please read number two?
Set realistic goals for change.
And altogether, let's read number three. Let change open new doors and point us.